Hi, my name is Bennet Duchin. I am 16 years old, and I've lived in Ashfield all my life. I spend my time hanging out at the lake, mowing lawns, going to school, and just enjoying our town. But I've always wondered if the things that are around today were here in the past. So I'm going to interview a lifelong resident of Ashfield and see how she enjoyed the town and see why she decided to live here her entire life.
I am Ruth Johnston Kraft, and I've lived here my entire life, which is 91 years. We're other children, but not very close by. And so I spent a great deal of my time alone, and I played with whatever toys I had at home, and did things around to help my father on the farm and my mother in the house and so forth. And then when I was old enough, I went to school, which was right across the road from where I lived. And it was a one-room schoolhouse with 8 grades in it. So I always felt that that's very fortunate, because if you don't get it the first year, you got 7 more chances to learn things. And then from there, from when you graduated from 8th grade, then I went into high school, which was Sanderson Academy up here in the village. And that was a 4-year high school. And the class were small, although mine was pretty average. There were 17 of us. And from there, I went to Northfield School for Girls for a year. And then I went into nurse's training in Cooley Dickinson Hospital for the 3-year term. You work and study for the 3 years.
Did the hardware store exist back then, and the and neighbors?
No, not neighbors. The hardware store, yes, but it was originally, when I was growing up, it was a grain store. It's in the same place that it is now, and the other half of it, where the pizza place was the post office. Mm-hmm. From a grain store, it became a hardware store.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom.
And I did all my grocery shopping right here in Asheville, because Elmer's store was a grocery store, with the meats and dry goods and everything.
Back to when you were younger, did you visit the library in the Ashfield Lake?
You know, when I grew up, we didn't have a car. Mm-hmm. And so I never hardly ever got to the lake. I don't remember swimming in the Ashfield Lake as a child 3 times, I don't think. I don't know if I did that. And I've seen a great change in that now, because the farms are gone, most of them, and which is sad.
Do you think it's possible in the world today for children to stay here their entire lives?
I think it's happening.
How do you think Ashfield will change in the next 100 years?
Who knows? I hope it stays country and appreciated, because to the point where people realize that they're living in a beautiful countryside. It's a privilege to live here.
For though they may be parted, there is still a chance.